Hi there, I'm Justin Wynn. I teach history here at Hastings College. I've been teaching history here for, well, almost a decade now, so I'm a bit of a fixer at this place. When you study history with me here, you'll have an interesting time, shall we say, and if you ever speak to any of my previous students, they will probably let you know that too. Throughout the course, which is a two-year course, we study various different components over the last 400 years. Now, the first component that you will be taught in history at Hastings College will be the Russian Revolution, and we will look at how between 1894 and 1924 the Russian population decided to rise up against their Tsar, their monarch, and replace him eventually with a communist regime, the first regime in the entire world that was communist. And then how did they consolidate their power and suppress their people in many ways. That's the first bit we do, and that would take us up to around Christmas in the first year. Then after that, we will then move on to British history between 1625 and 1701, looking at the political changes that happened in that era, such as the English Civil War and the execution of Charles I, the First Republic in Britain and the only republic, the Restoration, and so on. We then look at religious changes and how the Puritans tried to make Britain very, very austere, to the point of banning Christmas and Valentine's Day, which would probably be upsetting more than Christmas. We also, once that's done, throughout the first year, by the end of it, we'll start to consider your coursework. And the coursework is worth 20% of your overall grade, and it's based on a historical controversy of your choice. I don't necessarily need to make that choice, but if you can't think of something, I can come up with an idea for you. The things students have done in the past, we've had civil rights movements, the fall of the Mayan Empire, the fall of the Roman Empire, all sorts of opportunities there for you. So if there's something that you've studied over your GCSE or even individually outside that you're really, really interested in, that's an opportunity for you to dig deeper. And universities really like that, because what you're getting there is, you know, research skills that are going to be invaluable for your next stage in your academic career. And then in the second year, you'll start writing that. Now, generally what happens in the second year, we have two options that you can choose one of. The first one is civil rights, and we look at the civil rights movement in the USA between 1850 and 2009. We look at various step studies, but the general gist of that is why and how did America move from being a slave state in 1850 to electing its first black president in 2009? And is that indicative of actual civil rights changes in the USA? If you've been following current affairs, you'll probably say, actually, no, it's not indicative of anything. You know, Black Lives Matter. So big changes, little impact. The next option that you might want to take if you don't fancy doing civil rights is the witchcraft prosecutions in early modern Europe and North America. And we look at how over 200 years, prosecutions in witchcraft grew to a peak where in some cases you're getting almost 1,000 people executed in Europe just for being a perceived witch, to actually in court, the people that are making the accusations being tried for contempt of court. So that all happens in a big change there. And we look at some of the big witchcraft cases such as Salem and in Essex during the Civil War. And that's pretty much what you'll learn and what you'll be taught over the 2 years. I am the history teacher, so you will be taught by me. Classrooms, generally, there are two groups. And in each group, you'll get about anywhere between 15 and 25 students, depending which run they want to do. You have about 4.5 hours a week being taught in person, face to face. Obviously, things might change depending on what the current national situation is, but the plan is face to face, 4.5 hours a week, 2 years, and all your exams are at the end of those 2 years. If we're talking about success stories, we can think about a few students. I've had one student go to Oxford to study history. I've had other ones go to Canterbury to do archaeology, We've also got one just this year going to York to study archaeology as well, something that, you know, truly, truly passionate about, which was quite interesting because when they first turned up, they really didn't know what they wanted to do. And what I have managed to do via the history course is to inspire something in them so that they actually got a goal and something they want to do in the future. So certainly if you're one of those students that are unsure potentially of what it is you might want to do, being taught by me in history can inspire little sparks of interest that you can go forward. And you know, if you want to know more success stories, I've got absolutely tons of them. And I still talk to many of my students now. To get onto A-level history, it does help to have a GCSE in history. It's not essential. You don't need to have it. As long as you've got English at a sort of grade 5 or grade 6, that's going to be fantastic. The key thing I really need to see as a student of history is that you can write, and you can write fluently, and you can make an argument. If you like to argue with your parents, for example, that's always a good bit as well. You know, when they tell you you've got to tidy your room, and I'm not just talking about saying no, I'm talking about forming an argument where you actually convince them that you don't need to tidy your room. Over the years, we've done many trips in history as well. I've done trips to Hampton Court when we did the Tudors a few years back. The Tower of London's always a good one, certainly with the Stuarts and the Civil War. We've done Paris. I've taken students to Auschwitz as well when we have partnerships with the Holocaust Education Trust as well. So any of those sort of trips that we can do in partnership with people as well, we do trips to Parliament, always important, certainly with the Stuarts. Thanks for listening to me ramble on for God knows how long. It's been fun talking to you, hopefully. Are you in there? Yeah, you are, I see you. So good luck in your exams. Yeah, I suspect they are going to happen, so make sure you put the effort in. Take care, stay safe out there. It's been a pleasure talking to you, and if you have any questions whatsoever, please get in contact with the information line, or you can track me down in the college. You find out who I am. My name's Justin Wynn. It's not difficult to get hold of me. And if you know anyone that's doing history, they can possibly ask questions for you as well. All right, but stay safe.